Welcome to another Lone Star Gridiron Report. I'm Jeff Power, standing alongside Hank Carter, head coach at Lake Travis High School. First of all, Hank, thank you for being with us.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Let me get your thoughts, first of all, about where this all started. When you played at Eustis and you were your dad was a coach and you really got that feel of being a quarterback but having that father-son relationship.
Yeah, I watched my dad coach growing up. Me and my little brother were at practice every day, probably spilling Gatorade and throwing footballs around, jacking around. Watched him do that, and from the start, I knew that's what I wanted to go do. When I got to high school, my dad got out of coaching. My brother and sister were coming up, and so he could be at more of our stuff. He got out of coaching and just taught from there on. And I met Chad Morris my junior year in high school. He came in, and he was my quarterback's coach, and I just developed a relationship with him that still lasts to this day. And ended up going on, went to school, and when I graduated, I went back and I taught a year and coached a year there at Eustis, my alma mater. And after that, after 1 year, I went and joined Chad at Bay City, and I coached with him for 10 more years, Bay City to Stephenville and into Lake Travis. And and now he's up at SMU doing big things, and I'm still here loving what I'm doing.
And y'all knocked on the door over at Bay City. Just talk about just your learning experiences there with the Black Cats.
Well, it was awesome. I grew up in East Texas, a real small town, and I had a coach there that was a mentor of mine who was really helping me. He told me as soon as Chad got that job, I needed to pack my stuff and get down there with him, because he knew that Chad was going to be successful, and Bay City was a place at the time that was really talented. So we went down there, and the first year we won a state championship, and it was incredible. And I thought, man, this coaching gig is really, really easy. And the next year we got beaten a state championship by Ennis, and Graham Harrell was a sophomore that year, and they put it on us. The next year I think we got beat by Lamarck, and they went on to win the state championship. And so we had three great years there. Met my wife there too, so mm-hmm. I can't say anything bad about Bay City. I loved it down there. All the fishing too was pretty good. Went on to Stephenville, and Chad took the job. I went with him. There was never a doubt that I was going to go. That was a lifelong dream of his to go coach there. Thought it was a wonderful opportunity. Had five great years at Stephenville. Got to the semifinals. Never won a state championship there. Had a chance. Matt Stafford got us with about 20 seconds left in the semifinals that year in 05. And then, after the 2007 season, made the decision to come to Lake Travis, which was difficult at the time, but honestly is the best thing that's ever happened to me and my family, and just has been a blessing ever since. And so this is going on 8 seasons since I've been here.
So you were an offensive mind at first as a quarterback, but then you went to defense and you were the defensive coordinator for Lake Travis.
Yeah, I started coaching offense. When I started coaching at Eustis, we coached both sides of the ball as a small school. When I went to Bay City, I coached primarily quarterbacks, and then I worked with the O-line, moved my way up to receivers. And after about 3 years coaching with Chad on the offensive side of the ball, I figured I need to go try defense a little bit. I can't make this guy happy. And so I had an opportunity to go coach defense, and was able to move my way up to coordinator after 2 years. And I can't thank Coach Morris enough for the opportunities he gave me. And obviously had some wonderful kids that we had a chance to coach, and then climb the ranks that way. But, it's been a great ride, and hopefully we can keep it going here.
Of course, there was the 5 consecutive state championships. Yeah. No one can claim that same statement. Just your thoughts about being a part of that and being the head coach for 2 of them.
Yeah, it's like a dream, such a tremendous opportunity there. And when we came here, I can remember thinking, golly, if we don't find a way to win a championship that first year, they're going to run us out. I never dreamed we'd win 4 more. Mm-hmm. But such a wonderful experience. I've learned so much since coming here. It's really made me better. This is a challenging place to coach just because the expectations are high. Our parents are highly involved. Our kids are very talented, and they have the academic rigor in the school is a challenging thing. Mm-hmm. And so I think it keeps us on our toes, but it's a great spot. And now we just need to start our next run. It's overtime. We need to find a way to get back there. We've gotten close, made it to the semifinals in 13, but just Cedar Hill got in the way of that, and so hopefully we can get back there and start another run.
In spring last year, but it seems like you're always going up against someone really good in Region 2 for the most part.
Yeah, Region 2 and 6A. I mean, it's always been that way. Very talented, but if we want to win a state championship, we have to beat the best. And so, the teams that have knocked us off, they've played good on days that we necessarily didn't. And, they were good football teams, and they earned every bit of that. We have to be on top of our game. All the years that we won championships, there was always one or two of those games that we didn't necessarily bring our best stuff to. We got to find a way to win those. And, the past couple of years, we just haven't been able to, push through.
And finally, winning the game against Westlake, the importance of that, Great Lakes rivalry, and now, what, 8 in a row against the Shaps?
Yeah. I mean, it's awesome. Anytime that we can get a win versus those guys, it's tremendous. I mean, it's great for our program just because we know, how well coached those guys are. I know Coach Dodge very well. He and his staff have done a tremendous job there, and they are, a great opponent. It's a super experience for our kids going over there to a hostile environment like that and being able to get a win. There's nothing like it. There was so much energy in that stadium on Friday night. It's just incredible. I think that's a play. That's like a quarterfinal or semifinal type atmosphere over there the other night. And so, that's great for our kids. We learned a lot. We learned that we still have a long way to go. Coaching, too. I mean, we did a lot of things. I did a lot of things stupid the other night. I need to do better. And our coaching staff, we've got a long way to go, too, in some regards. But that was fun. That's the only way you kind of figure out what you need to get better at, is to be in some stressful games like that. So, you know, we're hoping for more of those and hope they end up the same way.
Final question. Can you win number six this year?
I think that we have a team to do it. You know, a lot of things have to fall into place. We have to keep getting better. That's the biggest thing. You know, we suffered a big injury to Abe Willows the other night. We've gone through that. Connor Floyd, you know, and we've had other guys in the past that have gotten hurt. So we need our troops to rally, and we need to pull together. And like I said, it's not up to one guy to take the place of Abe. We all need to step it up a little bit and come together and do this. And I think the key is, too, we need to treat it, take every week for what it is. It's a new challenge. It's a new team we have to get ready for. But I think that once you get into the playoffs, it's a tournament. Somebody's going to win it, and might as well be us. That's how we look at it.
Very good. Hank Carter, thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
LoneStarGridiron.com. Check us out each and every week. We've got your Coach's Corner right here in Texas. LoneStarGridiron.com. Access the complete history of Texas high school football, over 100 years of information, win-loss records, coaching histories, individual stats, records, and more. LoneStarGridiron, the authority on Texas high school football.